we just need to figure out what door this key opens. It has to be somewhere around the temple. We can open that big door anytime we want. Let's explore. Mimir, why did you say Tyr felt responsible for what Odin did to the giants?
There was an incident shortly after the forging of Mjolnir, when Tyr arranged a diplomatic meeting between Odin and the giants. And kings. Well, this was when the Long War was young, when victory was still a thing dreamed of, and the Jotnar might have tipped the balance between Aesir and Vanir. Odin had persuaded Tyr that the hammer was merely a deterrent, a means to broker peace from a position of strength. Tyr was hopeful to convince all parties they would prosper best through peace. He knew the giants were deeply concerned about the hammer. A super weapon in hands they did not trust, but they trusted Tyr. Tyr always believed the best in people, and taking Odin at his word in his desire for peace, he brought the Raven King to Jotunheim. From there, things unraveled quickly. The giants anticipated Odin's trickery and exposed his true agenda to spy and steal their secret wisdom. With magics, they expelled Odin from their realm and cursed him never to return. Frustrated, Odin visited his fury upon the giants of Midgard. Thor unleashed Mjolnir's might upon any giant he could find. None could stand against the tide of slaughter that followed. And at last, it seems, with Tyr's aid, they retreated. The tower disappeared, no giants could be found in Midgard, and no man nor god has set foot in Jotunheim since.
Hopefully you'll find some clues about the three legendary ingredients inside this stronghold.
What you're doing. where to next? Confused. I always heard that Baldur's mother was Frigg.
Aye, Frigg. Well, that's more of a pet name, you see. It means beloved, something Odin called Freya after they wed. Out of affection at first, or so I like to believe. As things turned sour, it became a way to manipulate the truth.
How so?
Odin didn't want Freya, a Vanir goddess, getting credit for anything in Asgard. So anything worthy she accomplished was attributed to Frigg.
Like being Baldur's mother.
That's right. Freya was Baldur's mother all along.
Whoa. I'm glad Brock and Sindri were able to work out their differences.
Now they are twice as irritating.
Aw, I think it's nice to see them trust each other again. Mimir, you never told us what Magni and Modi had to do with Hrungnir.
Oh, yes! Well, what happened after Hrungnir fell slain upon Thor was that nobody in the court could get the stone body off of him. Thor was no use at this point. His brain rattled, his breath shallow. But none of Odin's men were nearly strong enough to help. Then enter little Magni and Modi, no taller than shrubs. And while nobody but myself was looking, they flipped over Hrungnir's corpse and freed their father. Magni, being blonder, got all the credit, and Modi remained bitter about it from that day to the end, which I don't need to tell you about.
Wow, it's like there was an entire city under the water.
Aye, lad, a forgotten city.
What was it called?
Well, I forgot.
Ahead. Me.
I'm ready.
Oh!
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 Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh! Oh We've seen these runes before, but it's the kind I still can't read. There. Why did you work for Odin if he's so horrible?
It's my career! And if you mean to make your career as a counselor to kings, you can't very well rule out petty maniacs. Available positions are scarce enough. My first master was a cruel piece of work as well, but I learned through him the enduring power of wit, which served me well with kings and gods alike. I couldn't have been much older than you when I started. A fairy king's errand boy and unofficial jester. And we'll pick this up later.
Boy, over here.
It says, glory to Mozigo, the Dwarf King. May his reign be long, prosperous, and filled with peace.
Greetings, and welcome to Conan's Guard. I just want to make sure you're good and prepared before heading in any further. There's all manner of nastiness left over from the Mad Dwarf King's foul practices.
What kind of practices?
Oh, various sacrificing, dark enchantments, blood, magic, and so forth. Quite common among the older dwarves, unfortunately. Old habits are hard to break. I can do whatever you need. Isn't that neat? Oh, what? Nothing? Oh, okay. I'm feeling creative today. And what can I do for you? And back to you. Tidy up your knapsack. How about you, young one? Ooh, what more do you need? Oh, we can't forget you. That's fine. Always happy just to chat.
Whoa. Look, it's another dragon.
I see it, boy.
Chain. I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
Yeah!
apple doesn't fall far.
Boston's up ahead. More than one dragon. He must have needed them to create this legendary armor.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Teeth, scales, even excrement.
Excrement?
Shit.
Dragon shit is powerful?
Aye, lad. Totally powerful.
Ned is having fun with you.
Oh, I knew that. That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them, at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh. What's that?
Here we go! Wolverine!